Inspiration 4, the watershed mission of space exploration, is about to launch. If many times we have said this is the first flight of space tourists, then there has always been at least one small or large flaw that made us reconsider. We do not want to fuel controversy between space companies, but the SpaceX flight currently scheduled for September 15th has all the numbers to be a really pleasurable trip, touristy in fact. The Inspiration 4 flight will not go to the space station, as the first space tourist did from Dennis Tito onwards, but it will reach Earth orbit and it will stay there for about 4 days, floating in space as instead Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin flights did not do. The crew will be entirely composed of tourists, from pilots to passengers. They will depart from Launch Complex 23 at Kennedy Space Center aboard the Crew Dragon Resilient spacecraft launch from a Falcon 9. But there's more. After two billionaires have launched themselves into space primarily for their own benefit, a third, Jarek Isaacman, is about to take himself and three other civilians on a space venture undertaken not only for the love of the unknown, but also to raise funds for medical research. One thing is for sure, the prospect of space travel will be very different after the launch of Inspiration 4. We can, in fact, say with reasonable certainty that the date of departure, which at the moment seems confirmed for September 15th, will be the watershed between two historical eras. The one started with Gagarin, when orbital space was mostly a realm reserved exclusively for nations and to their selected astronauts, and the one after Inspiration 4, when space travel will be definitely within the reach of private companies and ordinary citizens. It's difficult to say what this transition will mean, whether space travel and its benefits will be democratized throughout society or will be exploited exclusively by corporations and the super rich. For now, the answer could be a bit of both. The events that led to Inspiration 4 were cast more than two decades ago. As some of you may remember, the private spaceflight market was opened by Dennis Tito, an American investment manager who in April 2001 paid $20 million to fly aboard a Russian Soyuz rocket to the International Space Station, where he stayed for a week, becoming the world's first space tourist. Only a little more than a year later, Elon Musk, then a successful software entrepreneur, would go on to found SpaceX, whose Falcon 9 rocket is now in the process of taking the crew of Inspiration 4 into an orbit even farther than that of the space station. At the time, as SpaceX was about to take off, figuratively and literally, Jared Isaacman was still a 20-year-old building the fortune that would eventually allow him a commander's seat on the first all-civilian SpaceX flight. How did he get there? Isaacman first contacted SpaceX and other commercial space companies in 2007, telling them he'd be willing to buy tickets aboard a space flight when they became available. It was a dream that could only materialize in 2020 after SpaceX's rockets had by then been chosen by NASA to carry its astronauts to the space station. And it was only after the reassuring outcome of those transshipments that Isaacman and Musk began planning Inspiration 4, announcing the joint project in February of this year. The crew, chosen entirely by Isaacman, is made up of women and men who have never experienced spaceflight. The goal is also unique, to raise money, and Isaacman has already donated $100 million for the research programs of St. Jude Children's Research Hospital in Memphis, whose operating costs are on the order of $2.8 million a day, but nothing is charged to patients. The intentions of the crew, it is therefore a flight full of symbols that they have carved out for themselves: leadership, hope, prosperity, generosity, designed to spur humanity onto better and better ways. Jared Isaacman embodies leadership. Founder and CEO of Shift for Payment, a digital payment platform, he will be the commander. Founded his company at age 16, earned his pilot license at 21, and went on to become a pilot of commercial and military aircraft, collecting several world records, from airshow performances to circling the world in jets in just under 62 hours. Hope is the story of Haley Arcaneau, 29, a medical assistant at St. Jude and the medical officer on board. Born in Louisiana at the age of 10, she was diagnosed with bone cancer, successfully treated at St. Jude. She now works at the same hospital. Haley will now become the youngest American to reach orbit. For prosperity, there is Cyan Proctor, pilot of the mission. Born in Hagania, island of Guam, USA, geoscientist, explorer, and specialist in scientific communication in Phoenix. In the field for generosity will be Christopher Sombrowski in the role of mission specialist, engineer and veteran of the U.S. Air Force, consultant for Spacecamp, a program to bring children and teens closer to space and science. He works as an engineer at Lockheed Martin. In addition to announcing the crew, Isaacman and SpaceX also outlined mission details. The launch is scheduled for September 15th at the earliest. The spacecraft will be in the air for 3 full days, flying in an orbit that will have the same inclination as that of the International Space Station, 51.6 degrees, but as high as 540 kilometers, an altitude about 100 kilometers higher than that of the space station. This particular orbit, Isaacman said, will be the highest reached by a human crew since the last space shuttle mission carried out in 2009 during maintenance of the Hubble Space Telescope. The decision on mission length represents a balance between the capabilities of the Dragon spacecraft and the length of time the 4 members will have to spend in a relatively small space. For the Falcon 9, it will be the 3rd flight, while Resilience, officially Crew Dragon C207, although modified, is that of SpaceX Crew 1, the first operational mission that brought NASA and JAXA astronauts to the space station in November of 2020. Notably, the docking system to the space station has been removed, and in its place is a giant dome that will provide the crew with an unprecedented 360-degree view of Earth. It is the largest window ever taken into space to date. To make the dome, glass wasn't used, but a special ceramic called aluminum oxynitride, or alon. This allows to have high transparency in the visible, but also in the near UV and near infrared. It's extremely hard and scratch resistant. At the moment, no precise technical information about the structure of the transparent dome of Inspiration 4 has been released. From what we can see in the images, will be used a double structure to ensure greater strength. There is also to consider that during launch and re-entry, and in part of the orbital flight, the transparent dome will be protected by the cover of the spacecraft itself. During the tests, it was also trying to make 2 people stay simultaneously with a positive result. The flight will not exceed 5 days, the maximum time for which the spacecraft was built before having to dock for supplies. It has not yet been declared what will be done on board, but it will probably be a nice tourist flight with very few tasks to perform, except to enjoy the view of Earth and space from a privileged position. The crew underwent a relatively short but very intense training session. Isaacman and Proctor learned how to control the spacecraft in the unlikely event that they are required to take control of it during the flight, which is expected to be totally controlled from the ground. During training, the 4 would-be astronaut tourists familiarized themselves with the spacecraft and its emergency systems, studied the launch operations of previous missions, and the ditching phases. Then the crew undertook zero-gravity flight training to familiarize themselves with the sensation of weightlessness and the immediate effects on the body. In mid-July, they donned SpaceX spacesuits for the first time, and on August 9th and 10th, they trained on decommissioned military jets to familiarize themselves with the gravitational forces they will be subjected to at launch. But how do you fly as a tourist in a SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft? Well, you climb aboard, strap yourself in, close the hatch and wait for the engine to fire up and start pushing you up. Nothing else. The Dragon takes care of everything, so you can relax and enjoy the ride, unless of course something goes wrong, and in space, something can always go wrong. And that will still force you to spend 60 hours a week in classrooms and simulators for several months, to master hundreds of pages of technical specifications and procedures, to learn the workings of dozens of onboard systems and subsystems, and to train for emergencies. The biggest risk aboard Dragon is a fire caused by a battery overheating, and there are a lot of batteries aboard the ship. Not only the spacecraft's own, but those that power the tablets, cameras, and smartphones the crew members will carry. There is also the risk of a spacecraft depressurization, requiring the crew to look for the breach, try to seal it off, and scramble into their suits at the same time. A launch emergency may occur even if, for example, the second stage of the Falcon 9 rocket that carries the ship to space fails to separate from the Dragon and the commander has to manually execute the separation maneuver. The Dragon's guidance system is also subject to failure, potentially causing the ship's solar panels to slip out of alignment with the sun and requiring human intervention to set things right. Fortunately, practicing for these eventualities aboard a Dragon requires a whole new kind of training, because in any case, it's 2021 and not the 1960s, when Mercury, Gemini, and Apollo capsules were designed with the cockpit of an airplane in mind. The sheet metal instrument panels were studded with hundreds of switches, dials, lights, and analog gauges. Onboard computers were controlled by a mechanical keyboard. The captain flew those ships the same way you'd fly an airplane, with a stick that determined speed, attitude, altitude, and heading. Dragon's designers replaced everything, including the stick, with three large touch screens in front of four side-by-side seats. Each screen can call up to 10 sets of displays, allowing the crew to focus on a particular set of systems: guidance, environmental, electrical, and more. Ideally, the spacecraft helps the astronauts so much that they have virtually nothing to do, with the ship operating completely autonomously. And if automation fails to buffer an emergency, then SpaceX ground controllers take over, who can troubleshoot and issue commands to the spacecraft from the mission control room. Only if the Dragon can't take care of itself and the ground crew can't fix the problem will astronauts take over. In this regard, Jarek Isaacman stated that he feels absolutely comfortable. He wrote, "I don't know that there has ever been a human spaceflight mission that did not have some anomaly. People are telling us we're making good progress. I think we've definitely arrived at the point where we're ready and this is going to be a well-executed mission. I've never seen a more innovative and impressive organization than SpaceX." It only took Elon Musk's staff 6 months to go from initial idea to actual mission accomplishment. Elon and his people are turning science fiction into reality every day, and Inspiration 4 is proud to be a very small part of the story that they are making. That's all for now. On September 3rd, teams from SpaceX and the Inspiration 4 mission met at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California, to conduct a flight readiness review of resilience, the Falcon 9 rocket that will launch it into orbit, the ground systems, recovery assets, the results of the astronaut training, and other key mission elements. After concluding that everything was good to go, a launch date was set for Wednesday, September 15th, with a backup launch date for Thursday, September 16th. Currently, both launches are scheduled to lift off by 12 a.m. Universal Time, 5 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The crew members are scheduled to arrive in Florida on Thursday, September 9th to commence final preparations for their mission. Approximately 3 days before liftoff, SpaceX will narrow down the launch window to 5 hours based upon weather conditions at the launch site, along the ascent corridor, and at landing locations off the coasts of Florida for a safe return of the crew and splashdown a few days later near the coast of Florida. Have a great trip, Inspiration 4, and good luck!